Planning for a trip is important, but just as important as planning is actually being prepared when you're on the trip.
Mm-hmm.
That's why I'm pleased to welcome you to the first ever installment of my Google Travel Tips series. In this video, we'll cover all the best Google Maps tips for travel, including how to create shared Google Maps. Hey friends, I'm Tasia, and welcome back to my YouTube channel where I share tech tips, app reviews, and a ton of Google tips. Are you ready to explore the best Google Maps tips for travel? Then let's go. We're going to cover helpful Google Maps search functionalities, how to share your location, how to save your parking spot, hailing a ride in Google Maps, different route options, how to download Google Maps for offline navigation. Plus, we'll cover how to create shared Google Maps with Google My Maps. Whew, we've got a lot to cover. So first, let's start with planning your trip. There's a few things you can do before you go on the trip to make sure things go smoothly for you while you're on the trip. Number one, get familiar with your route options. This is a handy tip for both web and mobile, and it's a great one if you're planning a road trip. From maps.google.com, after pulling your directions, tap on options underneath the destination. Here, you can choose to avoid highways, toll roads, and ferries. This is really helpful if you don't want to rack up a huge bill on those toll roads. Now, something else cool that you can do with the web features is you can also adjust the distance units too. So if you're already on your trip and that country uses kilometers, you can switch to that mode for better accuracy. And like I said, some of these route options are possible to be done on your mobile device. So this time you would just tap the menu icon and then select your route options from there. Tip number two when planning a trip is to create shared Google Maps. Now, this isn't the same thing as sharing your location, which I will get to later. This is creating a custom map and then sharing it with someone. So for this, you'll use Google My Maps. It's really easy. Here's how to do it. The first thing you'll do is head to google.com/mymaps. And if you're not logged into your Google account already, you're gonna be prompted to do so. Now you can already see that I've got a couple of shared maps created here, but it's really easy to create your own custom shared Google map. So click on create new map. And from here, make sure you title your map and add a description. So if you're planning your trip to Florence, Italy, you could make that your title and then add your little description and click save. Now in the search bar at the top, type in the name of the city you're going to go to and hit enter to bring that map up. Now here's where things get fun. We still have this untitled layer here, which is the map that we see right now. So you could name the layer the city name or points of interest or however you want to organize your map. With this layer selected, using the hand tool at the top here, we'll move around and zoom in and we'll find a place we want to drop a pin on. And now we'll switch to the add marker option and just click to drop the pin. Rename your marker to keep things organized. And you can do this for any place of interest, by the way, a restaurant, a museum, whatever. And to keep things even more organized, I recommend clicking on the paint bucket icon here and selecting an icon that best describes the location you're pinning. And you can also change the color of the marker here too. So once you have your entire map full of all your points of interest, it's time to share it. This is why this is so important when you're planning a trip. You could share this custom map with either those you're traveling with, you could share it with friends and family in another location so that they know where you are, or you could create it and then share it with friends who will be traveling to, say, your favorite city. You've already given them a short list of all the hotspots with the exact pins of where they need to go. What a great way to share the best things to see in a city with people in an interactive way. So once your map has all the points of interest your heart could desire, just click the share icon and this pop-up will appear and you'll have the option to email it directly to your contacts or share it via a link. It's really that simple. So now that the planning is done, it's time to actually take the trip. And lucky there's a lot of Google Maps features that will make sure your planned trip goes smoothly. Tip number 3 is search for needs and not addresses. Did you know you could search for something you needed in Google Maps, not just addresses? Well, it's true, you can. So if you're visiting somewhere and want to see all the grocery stores or restaurants or coffee shops or gift shops, you can either select the icon from the left-hand side of the map, or you could just type that into the search bar and then hit the search icon and look at that. You've got dropped pins on all the coffee shops near you, as well as a list on the left-hand side. If you click on one of the pins, the panel on the left will change to display the business info for that dropped pin. Now, these next few tips are for your mobile app pleasure. Tip number 4, save your parking location. Yes, please, a handy Google Maps feature indeed. To save your parking spot, just tap your blue location pin on the map and then select set as parking location. Now look, Google Maps displays that you are parked near here. Never forget your parking spot ever again. So what if you're not driving and you need to hail a ride instead? Enter tip number 5, hail a ride from a ride sharing company like Uber or Lyft directly from Google Maps. When you input a destination, scroll to the transit options underneath and then select the icon that looks like a little figure hailing a ride. And Google will tell you the different ride sharing services that are supported and how long it is to wait for one, as well as the price. And I love a good safety tip. And tip number 6 is to share your exact location with someone else. So tap your location dot on the map and then select share your location. You'll have the option to share for a set amount of time or until you manually turn it off. Your location is then stored in a viewable link that you can share in multiple different ways, like with your contacts or via messenger services or email. If you share with a friend that say you're meeting, they'll be able to see your location and then share theirs as well. So you both can see where each other are on the map. And not only is this going to share your location, but it's going to show you your battery percentage as well, which is really helpful. You can also drop a pin somewhere on a map that you want to meet someone or let someone know you'll be at that spot later. You just have to tap and hold the map and you'll drop that red pin. Then on the bottom, select the share option to share the dropped pin location with someone else. Talk about a major safety feature. Love it. And finally, we come to tip number 7. Download your maps for offline navigation. That's right. No data, no Wi-Fi, no problem. This is my number 1 favorite Google Maps travel tip. So from the city you are in or will be traveling to next, just select the menu icon and then just tap download offline map. If you want a full tutorial on how to download maps for offline navigation, you can click here or watch it via the link below. Remember, this is just the first installment of a whole series of Google travel tips that I'll be putting together for you. So if you guys have any specific travel-related questions or want to know specific Google travel tips, don't hesitate to ask by letting me know in the comments below. So what are your favorite Google Maps tips for travel? Let everyone know in the comments below. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, well, I wanna know. So give it a like, a share, or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel and here for even more Google Maps content. Thanks for watching. See you next time.